Hello everybody, in today's video we're going to learn how to resticker a cube without transfer tape. Now this one doesn't really need restickering. You can see it, the stickers are really nice still. This is a Shangxiao version 4, but I'm going to resticker it with stickers that I actually prefer, so I'm still going to take these off. The reason I don't use transfer tape, one, is because a lot of the time your stickers don't match your cube. And what I mean by that is if I take these stickers and I line up the top sticker on the top row, like this, you'll see the bottom is not quite in line. So if I was to use transfer tape on this, they would be out of line. And another thing too is when you use transfer tape, a lot of time you'll have bubbles underneath your stickers. Now I'm not the best at putting on stickers, so a lot of the time I still get some bubbles underneath, but to be honest, they don't really bother me that much. So what you're gonna need obviously is the cube that you're gonna use. It doesn't have to be a 4x4. This is more about applying the stickers, how to get the stickers off. So you're gonna need your sticker shades, and then you're gonna need some tweezers. Now there's a couple of different kinds of tweezers, and I like these ones that aren't like, you know, it's not a straight point like a pin. These ones here, you can see that there's more of a square side on that, and that's what I use. Now the first thing you have to do is take the current stickers off. Now you can use whatever method. You can use one of those sticker things that look like a plastic X-Acto knife, or you can use any, you can use your fingernail if you want to. I prefer this method, and that seems to work pretty good for me. I mean, like, now it's completely done. Now you'll find a lot of the time when you're done taking your stickers off that you'll have some glue residue. Now I've pretty much taken all of that off with that bang, but sometimes if you do have any glue residue, you can just hold the cube tightly and just rub it, and it'll end up coming off. Now sometimes it's very, very hard to get the glue residue off. So what I would use is something called Gooby Gone, and basically it's like the solution you can put on a rag, and it just really dissolves the glue and brings it back. So but anyways, I think that's good enough for me. So now we're going to learn how to resticker. So I'm going to do the white sticker first. So what I like to do is I like to turn this a little bit so they're not moving the layer. So if I go like this, now the layers can't really move. So what I do is I take the sticker and I hold it like this, and I take my pin and or my tweezers, and I bend it on the corner, and then you can see that it's now come off the transfer tape, okay? And I take it and I peel it off. Now I go to my cube, and what I wanna do is just eyeball it. Maybe I should have put that on there a little bit better. But you basically, the whole trick with this is to just eyeball it. You don't, you know what I mean? Like, basically I'm only touching this corner on first. I'm not sticking it flat down because I don't know if that's where I want it yet. I basically touch the corner and I eyeball it, and then I start sticking it down. And you can see that that sticker is perfect on there. So now let's go to the next one. Again, take your sticker paper, bend it till it comes off like this. Take it off with your tweezers, which transfers it there, and then go ahead and eyeball it again. That's pretty good for me. Now, don't get frustrated if you can't get it right away. It does take a bit of practice, and really this is like, you know, you gotta have a steady hand, but it's also just attention to detail. That's really all it is. I mean, so you line it up, then you press, and then you let go with the tweezers. One more. Now I usually like to rest these fingers against the cube for stability, so it's really, you know, I can move this around. If I was to go like this and try to put it here, see how much it's moving around? Because my hand isn't touching anything over here, it's just floating in the air. So if I was to try to do this, it could go wherever. But if I had the stability of the cube to rest against, now look, very, very simple, right? So again, line it up and stick it on. Now those four are perfectly in place. So I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward the rest of this, and then I'll show a couple for each color just to keep the video going for entertainment purposes. I mean, once I show you how to do one, you basically know how to do the rest. So anyways, I'm gonna keep going and fast forward it. See you in a bit. Okay, we're just on to our last one here. It actually goes pretty quick once you get good at it. One thing to keep in mind is once you stick it, it's pretty much stuck. So you really want to make sure it's on there straight first. As you can see, that's pretty straight now. A lot of the time, if you put it on crooked and, like, you know, more than half of it sticks down, you try to pull up, you're going to actually stretch the sticker, because they're made of the stretchy kind of, you know, plastic, I guess it would be, or paper, or coating. And a lot of time you'll stretch it and then it just won't fit at all. And if you only have one set, well, then that's just the way it is. So then after I'm done this side, I always go to the opposite side. So again, bend it till it comes up a bit. A lot of the time, if it doesn't come up, what you can do is just take your tweezers and flick it. Now it's up. Now you can get under there and apply the sticker. Do it again. See, this one I didn't put on quite straight enough to my liking, but you know what? It's on there. If I try to take it off, it is going to stretch out. So I'm not gonna fix it. I'm just gonna not let it bother me. And you can see that there's no air bubbles under here. You can see the light shimmer on that. Let's see on this side. There's no air bubbles. So that is a very good, oh, you can see one right there. You probably just push that one out the side and it's gone. Okay, fast forward. Okay, so now that the yellow and the white are done, I usually go on to the blue side. So stick one of these on. You know what? For some reason, I find blue stickers adhere a lot better for some reason, at least with CubeSmith stickers. Now, these ones come from ModCuber. ModCuber supplies really, really good stickers. In fact, my original plastic Zanshi that came from ModCuber has these shades of stickers on it. And I've done well over 1,000 solves with that cube, and there's barely any nicks or dings in the stickers. It's super, super nice. I highly suggest it. Now, I've been trying to ask him for his personal information again to see if he's up and running for a business or if this was just something he did for me. He hasn't replied to me yet, and I'm making this video now. But if his information and link is in the description, that means he is taking orders. Now you can see how fast this goes once you get fast at it, right? If his link is not there yet, either he hasn't replied to me or he's not in business right now. So either way, you'll know by the link. Come and check after a few days from now if the link isn't there. Fast forward. All right, so now that blue is done, I don't go to the opposite color. Actually, what I do is I put on red next. And I don't know why I do that. I could put on the opposite color, but I don't. Now, if you're wondering about the colors that I'm putting on here, the colors are a regular white. I don't think there's any other kind of white. regular yellow, regular red, and then it's bright blue and fluorescent green. I believe it's fluorescent, and fluorescent orange. And so it's not a half bright set. It's a little bit different. I used to only use half brights, but I almost stuck that on wrong. But I don't anymore. I was using the ModCuber Zanshi for a long time, and these colors are what ModCuber uses. Now, ModCuber uses CubeSmith. CubeSmith aren't bad. I prefer these though, and this is the color scheme I think that I will stick with. Now, ModCuber, I think, has actually come up with his own color scheme too. I would definitely like to try that out. I should have actually asked him to send some. I would have tested them out, but fast forward. You know, I gotta say, I really, really like this shade of red. It's a different kind of red that I've never seen before. It's a very like fire engine, very, very in your face kind of red. So now we move on to the green. I'm just gonna fast forward this whole one. You know, when I first started cubing, I watched Me, Myself, and Pi's videos a lot back in the day. And he showed tiles, CubeSmith tiles, and I became interested in tiles. And that's all I used for a long time. I still have some cubes that are tiled from back then as well. I don't like them now. I'm more about performance, and tiles definitely don't help with that. They look nice, don't get me wrong. I'd actually like to tile all of my Shapeways products. That would be really, really cool. But I don't use tiles anymore. There's a lot of things that I do now that I never used to do. I remember back in the day when I started, I would see speed cubers, and I'd tell my girlfriend, like, no way am I ever going to become a speed cuber. I like cubing, but I'm never going to be a dork. Now look at me. I have a YouTube channel, and I'm a big, big dork. But I like it. I like being this. Cubing is fun. Stickering is fun. Making videos are fun. And talking to a camera with nobody around is fun. Only to be put up on the internet for thousands to see later. It's fun. Oh, I almost put that sticker on wrong. Super fast mode. All right, last sticker. My timer on my actual, this isn't as long for you guys because I've been super fast moding, but for me, my timer now says 23:36. And I screwed up the first take a few times, and I started at 5 minutes. So it's been less than 20 minutes. And that is how you re-sticker a cube. Do somewhat of a checker pattern here so you can see how nice these stickers are. I really, really like them. In fact, I'm going to scramble and solve as soon as I hit stop. And then I'm going to start filming the second half of my review for the Shengxiao 4 that you just saw in my previous video. It's sort of like weird. It's like you get to go back in time, or I do, or I don't know, something like that. Anyways, I really like these stickers. I'm gonna solve it. I'll see you on my next video. Wait, actually I'll see you on my previous video, I don't know, how do I work this? Okay, I'll see you on my previous video.